So my name's Robin Carhart-Harris. I head up a research group at Imperial College London. We're the Centre for Psychedelic Research. We focus on how psychedelic drugs work in the brain and how they may be therapeutically useful. So since the 1960s, a certain Timothy Leary coined this term set and setting, at least in the context of psychedelics. And that's become a kind of buzzword in a way, a buzz term, since then. And now with the modern renaissance of psychedelic research, it's still there and it's very much in people's minds. And until recently, that had been mostly assumption. And it was good assumption, it turns out, you know, because now we've put a bit of data on those assumptions and tested things like that having a certain intention for the experience is more likely to lead to a certain kind of experience. And then we know actually now very reliably, it's one of the most reliable findings in psychedelic science, that the quality of the experience that you have is highly predictive of longer term mental health outcomes. So for example, if you have one of these profound mystical type, spiritual, the secular people would call them existential or maybe peak experiences. It doesn't matter, you know, choose your, I don't know, flavor. but the key thing is that the experience is the experience is the experience. And if you have these very intense experiences characterized by a sense of interconnectedness and oneness, then you're more likely to do well in the longer term. However, there's a bit of a kind of irony and a paradox there in the same way that when you meditate and maybe you want to achieve these jhana states of bliss, you know, don't go craving them and searching them, otherwise they'll evade you. And so there's this paradox where to have those experiences, the best intention and approach is in a way to just let go, you know, to surrender, to not strive for anything. And so it's good that now we have data to put on the assumptions that these things are important. We have data that it's important that you trust the people that are with you and looking after you. We're working on the assumption that integration work is important as well, and we'll get there, and no doubt it is important. But as things stand, we certainly know that what you bring to the experience in terms of your intention and willingness to let go, very important for predicting the quality of the experience that you have. That quality of experience being also contingent on the people that are with you, the quality of the environment, that it's not distracting, that it's not disrupting. And then you're more likely to have these big experiences that even if they're tough, if you stick to that willingness, a little bit like in a meditation, if you're sort of, these decoys are popping up in your head, think of this, or I'm not comfortable, I need to shift, you know, maybe I didn't turn the cooker off or whatever, you know, they're all decoys, but if you just sit with it, you know, then even if it's tough and there's turmoil, that you're giving yourself the chance, you're just giving yourself a better chance to have these big breakthrough experiences that can serve you so well in the longer term.